Okay. So, okay, you got my voice. Kita cakap kuat sikit lah.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
Okay, you got my voice, eh?
Yes.
You got my voice. Mm. Lepas tu, apa ni, based on my voice tu, you did the emo wave punya, some another software did the emo wave punya, whatever computation, right? And then you took the same recording, eh?
Same data, yes.
It's the same data, then you pass it into another software that you wrote yourself.
Actually, it's running on the same platform. The thing is running on different processing punya server lah.
Alright.
So basically, I have actually what we do previously, because I have actually written the software on a .NET platform.
Alright.
So now the software is actually sitting on a Zoho punya platform. So the processing is actually in Zoho punya platform. So what is happening is that we have this database filled with competency punya descriptors.
Okay.
So what we do, we have 9 core competencies, right? So now what we do, what we're looking at in the wave data, we're looking at the frequencies, because different frequencies is actually looking at different emotion. So contohnya macam you have your frequent and core emotion. So in that 5 minutes when you record your voice, the system is actually not recording, but it's actually processing about 1,440 triggers. Triggers mean emotions, whether it's frequent or core emotion.
Okay.
So under each emotion, there are thousands of descriptors to describe what is emotion, because emotions and feeling are two different things. Feeling is something that you can describe. Emotion is something that you feel but you cannot describe. Contohnya macam, you know, have you felt about the déjà vu? So basically, when we describe those emotions, there are a lot of descriptors involving. So
okay, when you describe descriptors, eh, from frequency, that means if you hit certain frequency, that means you hit certain frequency descriptor.
Yeah,
is that how you detect it?
Mm-hmm.
So if in my voice you can detect that frequency, that means I have that descriptor. Is that how it works?
Contohnya, for contoh macam there are many anxiety, many okay, anxious anxiety. Kalau macam anxiety, it's actually forward punya apa ni? Forward thinking, meaning that they worry about the future. Anxious pula, you know. Sorry, anxiety is someone who actually backward thinking. They worry about the past. Kalau anxious pula, it's actually forward thinking. They worry about the future.
How do you worry about the past?
So, from your previous experience.
Why would I worry about my past?
Contohnya, this is an example. Emotion is something like macam scars. Okay, I call it emotional imprint. So, take a knife, when you cut your hand, if it's deep enough, then you will leave a scar. Same goes with emotion. If that particular incident so tragic, so meaningful to you, it will leave an imprint. So you cannot forget emotion.
Alright.
So emotion is something you cannot forget for the rest of your life. In the wheel of emotions, it has been reported in one particular individual, there are about 3,000 over emotions, but the system will only record about 1,440 emotions, which is very important to us. But the emotion we cannot actually explain what it is. Yeah.
So okay, that's let's keep yang emotion lah. Then you come to competency.
Yeah.
That means if I have that frequency, I have that competency.
Because okay, contohnya macam anxiety. We will map whatever descriptors for the entire 1,440 triggers. So because we have different variable.
Triggers means that frequency.
Yeah. The emotion.
So I mean, but triggers is actually frequency.
Frequency lah. The top and bottom frequency.
I see.
So basically, what we do, each frequency tu dia ada banyak. Dia, if you look at the description of the particular emotion, thousands lines of descriptors. So what we do, we map it against our competency framework. There are 9 of it. So basically, we keeping score. Macam tick 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 tick, and then we actually make a calculation out of it.
Okay. Yeah. Then, how do you derive a person's competency based on the punya frequency of his voice?
Okay. Because what we believe in behavior. Because if you look at the pyramid of kita punya apa self punya structure. At the very bottom is what we call belief system and culture. Okay, something that we can learn. Right in the middle is actually what we call behavior. Okay, and then the top part of the pyramid is action. So whenever you feel, whenever we feel strongly of something, which is from your belief system, it will materialize into behavior. That's what we are actually mapping. Yeah, that behavior will materialize into emotion. So that emotion will be turned into action. For example, I give you. If you believe strongly about being fair skin is superior, what would you do? That's actually a belief system. Huh? You believe that fair skin is superior. What would be behavior translated from this? You will try so hard to be under the shades, right? So that you will not be under the sun. And then what sort of action that you will derive from this behavior? You will start using umbrella even it's not raining, or you start putting on, you know, cosmetic products so that you keep your skin fairer. So those are actually what we are looking at. So emotion will drive behavior, and behavior will materialize into action.
But competency is where?
Behavior.
But competency is behavior.
It's behavior.
Competency is behavior.
Yeah, it's behavior.
What are the 9 competency areas that you're looking at? Eh?
Okay, so we have. Okay, one second. What we are looking at, the 9 core: integrity and trust, drive and initiative, strategic planning and orientation, visionary outlook, leadership, result oriented, creativity and innovation, emotional intelligence and communication. So those 9 core competencies. But we also have a specialized competency. If you're an entrepreneur, you have additional 7 specialized competency. Then if you are a working professional, you have another additional 5. And then if you are you are a social entrepreneur, there will be an additional 7. So
entrepreneur ada 7.
Ada 7. Additional
7. Kalau social, apa? Social entrepreneur.
Ada 7.
Tapi kalau professional ada 5 ya.
Additional
5. Mana professional ni bodoh lagi daripada entrepreneur ni.
No, really. But actually what is required by the industry, because for entrepreneur they have certain additional competency that require for them to move up or to expand or to accelerate in their entrepreneurship deal.
Okay. Now once people dah known their competency, and then if they were to improve their competency in their weak area, does that will translate into a change in the frequency of their voice? Yeah.
It will, but not immediately.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it will.
So, nanti kata suara dia kecil jadi suara besar, suara kecil gitu.
That's actually what we call pitch. We don't measure pitch. We don't measure content. We don't measure pitch. But we measure the frequency. Contohnya macam if you were to make this sound, right? Contoh macam when we it is that what frequency. So sometimes when
that's not pitch. That's also pitch. No, pakai pitchfork. Oh, yang
the sound. But the what actually being translated. The vibration itu yang kita measure, not the pitch, not the content.
Oh, ni macam candlestick lah kalau stock market ni.
Not the
kan? Di light wave macam semua.
Not the content. So you can actually just speak macam whoa, but what we need is actually the vibration of your voice.
Okay. Alright. Anda bisa try dah. Anda bisa try kan? Okay. Let's look at my report. Okay.